Mambo, mnasemaje watangazaji wazuri. Nimekuirisha tena kwa programu ya Spotted. Naitwa Sheila. Ebu wacha nikuonyeshe kidogo hivyo nimekuletea in Spotted.
Nisamehe kwa imani yangu mbaya. Nisamehe.
Well, when we talk about change, we do not only talk about change in the president's office, but we talk about change in the way people live, call it the lifestyle. Now, when I talk about Tanzania, what comes into your mind? Probably Lake Tanganyika, Mount Kilimanjaro. But no, today I wanted us to talk about the man trending, the Tanzanian man who has trended all over the whole entire world, and that is none other than His Excellency, the Bulldozer, as he's known, John Pombe Joseph Magufuli. John Pombe Joseph Magufuli was born on the 29th of October 1959 in Chato District near Lake Victoria. His humble background endeared him to many poor Tanzanians who he promised to uplift as he knew what they were going through. During the campaigns, Magufuli talked of his father's grass-thatched house where he grew up herding to cattle, stealing milk, fishing to support the family. The 56-year-old father of five is a Catholic who loves singing in the church choir. Now, before Magufuli joined politics, he worked as a secondary school math and chemistry teacher and furthered his studies to become an industrial chemist. He was awarded a doctorate in chemistry from the University of Dar es Salaam in 2009. Well, I love Africa. We have a lot to feed on. God bless Africa. Now, when we talk about uniqueness, we need to talk about President John Pombe Magufuli. How many presidents do you know that have traveled from a country to another by road?
John Magufuli has been a member of parliament for close to two decades, having been elected first in 1995. He was first appointed Minister of Works in 2000 by the then President, President Benjamin Mkapa. In 2006, he moved to the Ministry of Lands and Human Settlement, where he served for 2 years, having been appointed Minister of Livestock Fisheries in 2008. His soon-to-be predecessor, Jakaya Kikwete, moved him back to the Ministry of Works in 2010, where he served as the minister until his election as president.
Sorry about this. In Africa, we get to eat anything as long as it's eatable. Now, back to Magufuli. Well, in Magufuli's country, you can't talk about celebrating national holidays when people are going hungry. He would rather feed the hungry and do away with national holidays. Secondly, he sees no sense in having over 70 cabinet ministers when there are no drugs in hospitals. He would rather put drugs in hospital and cut down the number of cabinet ministers.
In a surprise vote, John Magufuli, 56, was nominated by the Tanzanian ruling party, Chama cha Mapinduzi, CCM, to succeed President Jakaya Kikwete in October election. Magufuli, who was not considered as one of the top contenders to the throne, beat 38 other candidates, including former Prime Minister Edward Lowassa and the current Foreign Minister Bernard Membe. Magufuli won CCM's presidential ticket on July 12, beating about 40 other contestants, notably Tanzania's first woman to declare their presidential ambitions, the former UN Deputy Secretary General Asha Rose Mejiro, and the African Union Ambassador to the United States, Amina Salam Ali. Magufuli was not considered as one of the top contenders to the throne, but beat 38 other candidates, including Prime Minister Edward Lowassa and the current Foreign Minister Bernard Pembe. He is Tanzania's fifth president after Julius Nyerere, who ruled 12 years before introduction to the 10-year term limit, Ali Hassan Mwinyi, Benjamin Mkapa, and Jakaya Kikwete. John Magufuli has been a long-term friend to Kenyan opposition leader Raila Odinga, a fact that is said to have caused rumbles in the Jubilee coalition where he clinched the CCM nomination. The closeness was witnessed when he attended the burial of Raila Odinga's son, Fidel Odinga, in January, and when Raila traveled to Tanzania to personally congratulate him for being nominated as the CCM candidate. However, that relationship is not expected to affect Kenya-Tanzania diplomatic ties, as Kenya's Deputy President William Ruto said Jubilee would work freely with anyone elected in Tanzania. Asante sana kuwa nami on Spotted. Now, when we talk about setting trends, Magufuli has suddenly set a trend. Now, recently, our very own President, His Excellency General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, visited Mulago Hospital without prior notice. Now that's when I say congratulations, President John Pombe Magufuli. Africa is suddenly copying a leaf.